This third episode in the 2019 introductory series to Unidata's Integrated Data Viewer explains the basic controls available in the Map View window. I've created a sample project showing a 3D semi-transparent isentropic surface. Right now, it looks flat. The buttons on the upper left-hand edge of the screen are used to control the viewing perspective. Right now, we're looking at data from above. We can also look from below, which looks kind of strange, from the north, from the east, from the south, or from the west. We can also return to the original plan view from above. These views let us see profiles of the 3D surface and are great for data editing, but different angles would convey the topography better. This button toggles plan view. Once we turn it off, the shape of the surface can be seen even from above. We can also rotate the image by holding the right mouse button and dragging. The perspective buttons still work in this mode. We can also use these buttons to zoom in or out, pan right, left, up, or down, or to undo the most recent perspective change. The cute house button takes us back to the home view in plan mode. Right-clicking and dragging does work in plan view, but it may distort your image. If your wireframe box doesn't look like a box, try turning off plan view. Animation controls are in the upper right. Hitting play will create an animation using all available data times. You can click on any frame to stop the animation and see that frame in more detail. To view a smaller area, it's normally a good idea to restrict the data domain. The IDV has adaptive resolution, so you'll often see more detail when viewing smaller areas. To select your new domain, hold the Shift key and left mouse click button and drag the cursor to create a box. The map view window isn't just for changing your angle. You can also edit your displays here. I've created a sample display of brightness temperature to demonstrate. Let's zoom in on a small area to see the detail. To take full advantage of adaptive resolution, it's important that we allow the display's size to change. Now when we zoom in, the picture doesn't seem to have changed much. This is probably because we're at the limits of the dataset's resolutions rather than the display's resolution. The contours are a bit farther apart than I would like. We can fix this by decreasing the contour interval. Now the image looks a lot smoother. After zooming out, we do have to reselect the larger domain before we can see the display outside of our smaller domain. Sometimes changing the color bar can help you highlight key features in your data. There are several default color bars available, but you can also edit any one of them to create your own color scheme. It's possible to hide individual displays to see what they might be covering up. There's nothing behind this display. To get rid of the display permanently, you can throw it in the trash can. If you'd rather make it more visible, you can bring the display to the front. This is mostly useful when you have several displays in your figure. We only have one here. At this point, you should be pretty familiar with how the IDV is laid out. The next video will get you to the point where you can create your own basic displays and bundles. As always, you can visit our webpage at unidata.ucar.edu or email us at support-idv@unidata.edu.